First of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. But I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs. So I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular. In other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Okay, hello lovely Leo, this is your overview for the month of July, your tarotscope, angelscope and astrological overview for the month of July 2017. So, just gonna shuffle, and also, just first of all, just looking at the astrology. So we've got the Sun in Cancer for most of the month, and for you that will mean, Leo, that there's a big focus on your 12th house. And 12th house issues are very much to do with our own connection with the divine, our connection with God, very much to do with our psychic ability, our ability to tune in and to connect and to receive spiritual nourishment and nurturance, if you like, to be divine channels as well on this earth. It's also the house of karma. It can also be a house in which we find that we are able to withdraw within ourselves, to come to the truth of all the things that we are ready to heal and to let go of from past lifetimes. And it's also the house of faith, of trusting that we have everything that we need in order to move ahead. And for you, because Cancer is very much about emotional well-being and nurturing, right, I'm just hearing stop. That's going to be a place where you, Leo, in the month of July, find a lot of your strength and your emotional well-being. It will be through your spirituality and through faith in yourself and faith in the future. And I've just heard self-reliance as well, so that's very interesting. Okay, so let's see what the cards say for you for the month of July. Truth. That's a very interesting one. So it's going to be very much a time for you to be coming to terms with your deepest emotional truths, to really, really get clear with yourself about what you want, what makes you happy, what gives you a sense of space and freedom and joy in your heart, and what doesn't. This is just what I'm feeling just coming through. It's going to be a time for you to embrace a higher truth about yourself, about your life, with wisdom and spiritual maturity, and a time when you will learn to really begin to trust that inner light, to trust the faith that you can have within yourself about the direction your life is taking, about the direction your life has taken so far, and about your ability to continue to move through your life with joy and joyful expectation, regardless of who comes and goes, regardless of who is in your life. It's about your own inner truth. Okay, so let's see what crosses that. And awareness, wow, that's beautiful. I mean, look at that. Another card that's very, very highly, highly spiritual. So it's going to be a month of real awakenings and realizations and epiphanies for you, Leo. A time when you finally get to figure out a few things about what it takes to make you happy. Fantastic, isn't it? So that looks really good. All right. So rest and rejuvenate. So it looks as if there's been a lot happening. There's been a lot to overcome as well. You've got obstacles and challenges there. And things are sort of beginning to iron themselves out a little bit now, but it also feels as if it's time for you to really take on board everything that's happened recently and everything that you need to let go of in order to feel really good in your day-to-day reality and in terms of your spiritual as well as your emotional well-being, to let go of the things that disrupt you, that upset you, that spoil your day, that take your smile, that take your peace, and just to allow yourself to be at peace without feeling you have to overdo things or overwork it or prove anything to anyone. That's what you've got hanging over you at the moment. And when I say hanging over you, that sounds awful. It's not hanging over you. It's offering you an opportunity to just give yourself some time and space and maybe get out into nature as well and just receive some love now. You've been giving out an awful lot. It's time for you to receive some love. Okay, so obstacles and challenges that have been overcome. And, you know, it's interesting that that's a five as well. Spirit were drawing my eyes to that because, you know, the fifth house, the Leo house, is very much about this. The sun rules Leo, and Leos need to be switched on and full of joy and full of love and full of this light, this strong heart energy, this lion or lioness energy. And, you know, having five as this card of obstacles and challenges, it's kind of like your light has been a little bit dimmed, your fire has been a little bit sort of dampened recently, and you're coming back into that, and it's through having time to rest and rejuvenate. Okay, so moving through the crown chakra. So you're moving out of a phase anyway that's been highly spiritual, where you've been asking for answers, you've been asking to be shown the way so that you make the right decisions and the right choices, and that's lovely. This card comes up a lot this month, so it's going to be a time to really be clear about choosing wisely as you go into the next phase of your life, as you make the next series of decisions that you need to make. And I'm sorry that this is, you know, it doesn't sound very much to do with the physical reality, but that is what came up at the beginning, that it was going to be very much a spiritual time. So a time of self-reflection and a time of spiritual connection. And let's just accept that, because that's great. That's really, really, sometimes we need those months. We need those months that don't seem to be about anything in particular, but in fact, oh, they really, really are, because they give so much fuel to our physical and material reality when we're ready to re-emerge into that consciousness. It's like recharging your batteries, but it's also like regrouping and gathering and being able to receive the new inspirations for the new ideas that will take your life forward the next month, the following month, okay? Which is, your month. So that's perfect, perfect that you're in that 12th house place. Okay, so temptation. So your attitude to all of this, there is a temptation to just, I don't know, it's almost like an agitation that I get with this card. This card has got so many meanings, but basically what it symbolises is straying off the path of peace, in a sense. That's the way I'm hearing it at this time. Without placing all these judgments and these sort of huge archetypal extremes on it, It's about, you know, we already know we came from an Eden, from a paradise, and there was disruption there that took us off that path of paradise, so that in a way we'd know just how happy we were and how beautiful and safe and serene and sacred that paradise was. And that's all this is. There's a temptation there within you to stir things up just because it feels as if there's nothing happening. And also, you know, any kind of addictive behaviours, any kind of forcing the issue with family or with work or with projects or anything like that, anything that you've become used to doing, it's time for you to look at those habits and to really learn to step back and step out of it and let people sort themselves out and sort their own lives out, and just allow yourself to take that back seat that you need to take in order to feel good. And allow yourself to keep feeling good when you do. Allow yourself to just shine and just feel good. Don't get drawn back into addictive relationships or patterns or ways of being in a relationship or arguments or struggles with family or anything like that. Just let it all go over your head. Let it just roll off like water off a duck's back, and just move on. Move on. I feel that you've allowed yourself to get drawn into things. Drawn into disagreements. I've got to put the clock on for you as well, Leo, so your reading might be a bit longer. Okay, so environment, the waiting game. Okay, waiting to hear about something, waiting to hear from someone, waiting for the dust to settle is what I'm hearing, waiting for things to just sort of calm down again. So it's almost as if you know, something's about to happen, something's about to change things in your environment. Maybe someone's about to go away, or someone's about to arrive for a visit, or you're about to step out onto a new path, but you're waiting to get some news about it. I feel as if you're thinking of doing any major reshuffles or changes, it is an important time for you to wait and to rest and to recuperate, so that your next actions will come from a much more inspired place. And that's one of the reasons that you're being asked to just play the waiting game for a little while. Hopes and fears, light, wanting to be connected with the light, wanting to definitely make your decisions from a very spiritual, very enlightened place. I feel as if you're kind of tired of this old energy now, tired of tripping yourself up, tired of being tripped up, tired of being drawn into things that you don't want to get involved with, and being pulled off the path of peace, and wanting to just stay in the light, wanting to receive real, genuine wisdom now that's lasting, and wanting to shine as well. For some of you, this will be about wanting to step out into the spotlight as well. I know Leos love to be in the spotlight, where they can be the full expression of all that light and all that sunshine that they bring to the world, all that love that they bring to the world. So there's a real hope that when this period is kind of, has come through, as sort of, I can't find the right words for it, it's a vibration that I'm looking for. When this period has sort of worked its way through, you're hoping that this will be the kind of energy from which you can launch all of that light out into the world. And that's absolutely that feels absolutely right, because you're gathering all of this awareness at this time, and you're resting, and you're learning how to not get drawn into stuff that you don't need to get drawn into. Okay, so what's the outcome? Material harvest. That's great. That's absolutely great, Leo, because what that means is that you are gaining mastery over all of your circumstances, over all of your environments, your wishes, your hopes for the future, your manifestations. And you're doing that by staying calm, because you've already created a lot of things. There's a lot of really good stuff around you. There's a lot of good stuff that you've put out there, and you've put out there, and you've put out there, and you've tried this, and you've done that, and you've seeded this, and you've seeded that, and you've nurtured this, and nurtured that. And it's like this whole reading is saying, you almost don't have to do anything in July. It's a time to reflect. It's a time to receive some love, receive some healing, receive the reflection and the inspiration, so that when you do burst forward in your month, in August, and you take all of this lovely explosion of light with you that you're filling up on now, you will see the material harvest for the work that you've put in the past. Going back, I've just got the number 5. Going back 5 years, I know we said that about the 5th house, but it's another 5. Going back 5 years, and there will be change. There will be change of a very positive nature. Let's see what the other card is on top. Okay, so we've got conflict and defeat, followed by patience and planning. All right, so that conflict and defeat card, I'm just going to pick some cards from the Dolphins and Mermaids deck just to see what we've got. What can we receive about that spirit? Why are we seeing that conflict and defeat card next to the material harvest? Please give us some more clarity for Leo for what they can expect in the month of July, end of July, when they emerge from their period of reflection. Let's see. Past. Your intuition is correct. Take action accordingly. So whatever you're planning now, you're moving out of a phase of thinking, right, yes, this is the right thing for me. I know it's the right thing. I'm going to go with this one. And where you are now, soulmate relationship, new romance with a spiritual basis is here for you now. So there's a possibility that there is a partnership that you are evaluating. It doesn't necessarily have to be a love connection, but it's possible that you're thinking of joining forces with someone. And it's also possible that within yourself, you are achieving more of a union and more of a sense of self-partnering, because remember, self-reliance came up at the beginning. So it could be that you are dropping some of your expectations about partnership and what partnership should do or be or bring into your life, and that self-reliance is coming from partnering with yourself, being your own soulmate in a way, and understanding that all of this spiritual searching and going inward is bringing you to a greater place of completion, of understanding, so that when people do come along, their input is just like the icing on the cake. They're not, you know, there's no one there that needs to fill a gap for you. There's no one there that needs to fill a space. You are going to be attracting out of this sense of completion within you, and you can attract from that place a partner, but they'll be the right partner. So that's where you are now. Real perfection, perfectedness and completion within yourself, really coming together in a spiritual sense. And empowerment, complete empowerment. Okay, I understand. Right, so this has come up, something similar has come up before, where, you know, if you speak too much about what you're planning too soon or to the wrong person, sometimes, you know, they can say something that can throw you off, or you can start to doubt yourself because you don't get the response that you want, or, you know, your plan's too fragile, it's too soon to speak and you've spoken and it's out there. And, you know, what I would say is that it seems to be that the road that you're traveling at the moment, where you are doing this spiritual searching, where you're connecting with your inner faith and your sense of self-reliance, you're walking your own sacred path and manifesting from that place, all of that is leading you towards this material harvest, this wonderful material harvest that we that came up earlier, where you could experience being thrown off slightly is if you fail to take your own complete empowerment and you start thinking, oh no, but I want someone to do it with me, I can't do this on my own, and you know, and that brings the wrong energy around it, or you speak to someone who is not necessarily on the same page with you, maybe someone who traditionally isn't on the same page with you, someone you might already know who this is, and because you feel, you know, or I should really let someone know. And then that brings that sense of, oh, I shouldn't have said anything. Why did I say anything? I knew I was going to get that response. So, yes, there is partnering. There is a possibility of partnering with others outside of yourself. But it can only happen from an energy of complete self-reliance. I hope that makes sense. Where you're not looking out of need for someone to stitch it all together for you at the last minute, but it's complete, you're complete, you love and have complete faith in yourself and your vision, and then, ta-da, the universe delivers the perfect reflection of that. And then you remain empowered because it's still all about your journey because you have that complete faith. Okay? So you're more powerful than you realize, the card says. It's safe for you to be powerful. So the whole of July for you, Leo, is going to be about recognizing how powerful you are through going inwards, developing or reconnecting with already developed spiritual practices, going in deep, okay? Really make the most of this month for doing that, because what will happen when you emerge from that, when the sun goes into your sign, okay, at the end of July, what you will gain from that will take you much further forward than any thrashing about or working from a place of instability, inner instability. Okay, so it's time well spent is the point. Okay, so I hope you have a wonderful month, Leo. It's going to be a fantastic summer for you, a really, really great time of really reconnecting with yourself, and a lovely month for you in August. So wishing you all the best for July. If you'd like to have a reading with me, just click on one of the links below the video, and I will speak to you again soon. Okay, bye.